Hey everybody, today we'll be discussing database normalization. First, we need to define the term normalization. So what is normalization? It is a process of organizing relations and attributes of a relational database to improve data integrity and to eliminate data redundancy and inappropriate functional dependencies. This is the late Dr. Edgar-Frank-Codd, the inventor of the relational database model and the proponent of normalization. He introduced the first three normal forms and later proposed the Boyce-Codd normal form together with Raymond Boyce. So how do we normalize a database? We test a relational schema to certify if it belongs to a certain normal form. This involves arranging attributes based on dependencies between the attributes and ensuring that it is properly enforced by database integrity constraints. This is mostly accomplished through synthesis and decomposition. How do we know which attributes to arrange? We check their functional dependency. Functional dependency is a relationship between two attributes from a relational database, which is denoted by this figure, read as X determines Y. In this example, the invoice number determines the item, the quantity, the date sold, and the customer. Thus, if we know the invoice number, we can retrieve the item, quantity, date sold, and customer. Under the example, the number of items determines the total price. If an item costs 120 pesos, we can determine the total price by multiplying the number of items by 120 pesos. There are three initial normal forms, and they are conveniently called the first, second, and third normal forms, 1NF, 2NF, and 3NF respectively. As the idea for normalization began to rise, three additional normal forms were introduced, the Boyce-Codd normal form we mentioned earlier, as well as the fourth and fifth normal forms. We will discuss all the normal forms, starting with the first normal form. For a schema to be in 1NF, it should satisfy the requirement of atomic data. It shouldn't contain columns with repeated or similar data. Duplication of rows is not allowed, and each field should have a unique name among other fields. Now let's take a look at this table, a sample invoice table. The fields invoice number, date, and amount are already in its atomic value. However, the field customer name can still be broken down to two fields such as customer first name and customer last name. Let us make some changes to the table. As you would notice, we have split the customer first name and customer last name into two separate column fields, and thus, now they are attributes with atomic values. However, item column is incorrect. Why? Let's take a look at our rules again. The invoice table violates the first rule in that column should only contain atomic values. The item column has multiple data inside. We need to separate them. By making another record for the second item, the item column now has atomic values. Our table now conforms to the first normal form. We now move on to the second normal form. For a database to be in second normal form, the schema should already be in the first normal form. In addition, attributes other than the primary key should be dependent on it. To this end, any table that is in 1NF that has a simple primary key is also considered in 2NF. Our invoice table is already in the first normal form, but the item column is not dependent on our primary key, the invoice number. It should be split into another table. We can simply link the invoice table and the items table using a foreign key in order to associate an item with an invoice. We are now at the third normal form, the last of the initial normal forms proposed by Dr. Codd. A relation or table is in third normal form where the following conditions are met. It is the second normal form, and no transitive dependencies exist. What is a transitive dependency? A transitive dependency is a functional dependency between two or more non-key attributes in a relation. This can only happen on a table with three or more columns. In this figure, X determines Y, but Y does not determine X. Y determines Z. So if X determines Y and Y determines Z, X should also determine Z. In our invoice table, the invoice number determines the date, amount, customer ID, customer first name, and customer last name. The customer ID column can also determine the customer's first and last name. This is a transitive dependency, and we need to separate these columns like we did in the second normal form. We now have a customer's table that links to the invoice table via the customer ID. This schema is now in the third normal form. The last of Dr. Codd's proposed normal forms is the Boyce-Codd normal form, or BCNF. BCNF is a stronger version of 3NF, and its objective is to address the anomalies found in 3NF. For a table to be in Boyce-Codd normal form, the table should be in the third normal form and should contain any trivial dependencies between keys except the primary key. A trifold dependency, you ask? A trifold dependency can be shown in this figure. W determines X, Y, and Z. X and Y, as a combined key, determines W and Z. But Z also determines X. This is a trifold dependency. This can be solved by separating the relation into two relations. The table with W, X, Y, and Z attributes is split into two tables, one with W, X, Z as attributes, and one with Z and X as attributes. Here's our items table earlier, with a new attribute called supplier. This table conforms to these rules. Each invoice can contain many items, and for each item in it has only one supplier. However, each item has several suppliers. Each supplier supplies only one item, but each supplier can supply the item to several stores. Since an invoice can have many items and several suppliers for each item, having the invoice number as the only primary key is not enough. To convert the table to BCNF, we separate the item column from the original table and create a new table with supplier and item as fields and link the two tables together using the supplier attribute. The schema is now in Boyce-Codd normal form. We move on to the two other normal forms. This includes the 4th and 5th normal form. We'll start with the 4th. Here are the rules for 4NF. The database should be in Boyce-Codd normal form, and it should contain multivalued dependencies already, because 4NF will add those. A multivalued dependency is a type of dependency that exists when there are at least 3 attributes in the schema. For each value of X, there is a well-defined set of values for Y, and a well-defined set of values for Z, but the sets of values for Y is dependent of Z. Let's take a look back at our suppliers table earlier. There's now a new column called the color. For each item, there's a supplier for it, and there's a color for the set item. However, supplier and color is independent from each other. We split the table into two, the suppliers table and the items table. The suppliers table has a supplier name and the item it carries. The items table contains the items and the color of that item. This is now in the 4th normal form. The last form we'll be discussing is the 5th normal form. 5NF conditions are that the schema is in the 4th normal form and the attributes of the multivalued dependencies are related. This is our suppliers table, with a new column called the shop name. This is in 4NF, but not in 5NF because there is a lot of data duplication that's happening. There's no other solution but to break this table into 3. We now have the suppliers table, the shop items table, and the shop suppliers table. The suppliers table tells what items and suppliers bring. The shop items table tells what shop carries what item. And the shop suppliers table tells what shop is being supplied by what supplier. The two new tables will be associated using supplier and item respectively. This is solved in the 5th normal form. With all that said, why should we normalize our databases? What are the advantages of having a normalized schema, and what are its disadvantages? Normalization makes databases more robust, as it reduces data redundancy and ensures that they stay coherent whenever you create or update them. In normalized databases, verification code tends to be simpler and smaller. The same goes with update and creation transactions, as you typically don't need to enter the same data in more than one table. When done properly, you can also reduce the amount of disk space needed by the database, as normalization would allow for data reuse. However, normalization is not without its problem. Normalized databases will typically require more tables to access when retrieving data for a single entity. This means more lookups, and therefore, slower retrieval transactions. In addition to that, you will need to manually compose rows from multiple tables in order to retrieve that entity into a usable form. This means more complex lookup code. In some cases, performance might be more important. If this is the case, denormalization is done to avoid this disadvantage. This concludes our lesson on normalization. I hope you learned a lot today about this topic. Don't forget to like this video and do share this with your friends. Thanks and goodbye. Created using Powtoon.